very, very good morning. Greetings in the precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. This is your friend and pastor, Carlo Lord, coming to you once more from the First Baptist Church of Paraiso, Panama, the Republic of Panama. This is practically, so to speak, beloved, the month of Thanksgiving. This is the month when we celebrate Thanksgiving. And as you know, last Thursday, in most places, Thanksgiving was being celebrated by many people. Today, I want to talk about who is the reason for Thanksgiving. Who is the reason for Thanksgiving? And right off the wheel, you know, we should know by now that Jesus is the reason for Thanksgiving. Jesus is the reason for Thanksgiving. I want to read from a very well-known portion of Scripture, taken from John chapter 3 and verse 16. Read, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." Let us pray. Father, thank you for this another blessed day that you have blessed us with, that you have granted unto us. We thank you for watching over us through the night and waking us up this morning, Lord, in our right minds. We pray this morning that as we listen attentively to your word, your spirit will be the one to guide us and teach us and help us, Lord, to understand thy word. This we ask in the blessed name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Yes, beloved, Jesus is the reason for Thanksgiving. Now, I'm sure we all love Thanksgiving. To most people, however, it's the time for turkey. It's the time when families get together to have fun. But it is also the time we remember all those who have been very, very good to us. In other words, who have been a blessing in our lives. Now, it's always good and only right to be thankful and to give thanks. But this is not a once a year thing. First of all, we should give God thanks for sending his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, to die on the cross for us, as we read in John 3:16. The Apostle Paul knew how crucial it was to give thanks, and he gives us, beloved, at least four other good reasons why we should be thankful. First of all, because God wants it. We are told to give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God for you in Christ Jesus. And we find that in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 and verse 18. We thank him for his provision. We thank him for making us clean by taking our sins away. We thank him for his Holy Spirit who guides and comforts us. The Lord was displeased with the Israelites for their constant complaints. The Lord heard it, and his anger was kindled against them. Numbers chapter 11, verses 1 and 2. Then, secondly, beloved, everything comes from God. We should be thankful to God this morning because, honestly speaking, everything comes from God. We have been enriched in every way, in all your speaking and in all your knowledge. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verses 4 and 5. There is not a single thing, beloved, not a single thing we own, nor a single thing about who we are that has not been given to us by our God. Our parents, the house we live in, the food we eat, the clothes we wear, everything comes from God. Even the very breath that we breathe, They all come from God. And note this, beloved, we will never be able to outgive God. Then thirdly, a lack of thanksgiving keep us from moving forward. Don't you forget that now. A lack of thanksgiving keep us from moving forward. God said in Exodus 16 and verse 12, I have heard the grumbling of the Israelites. God said that. Look at Exodus 16 and verse 12. He heard the grumbling of the Israelites. Now, after God led the people out of Egypt toward the promised land, they spent their time in the desert, beloved, complaining. Now, as a result, their eyes were taken off the big picture, which was reaching the promised land. Now, that caused them to spend more time in the desert than they should have. The promised land was just up ahead, but their lack of thankfulness kept them from making the very next step to go into it. Then, giving thanks changes our perspective. Giving thanks changes our perspective. When we are thankful, we turn our eyes off of ourselves and we look on to Jesus. Remember what the Bible tells us, beloved? Looking on to Jesus, which is the author and the finisher of our faith. Our hearts are stirred with joy, and that joy begins to overflow, resulting in us becoming more and more like Jesus. Beloved, thanksgiving is good. Like I said earlier, it's not a once a year thing. This is something we should practice in our daily lives, to give God thanks for everything. The art of thanksgiving should be consistent, it should be steadfast, and it should be genuine. May God help us to learn to be thankful people. There's a hymn, I don't know all the words of it, but it's in our hymn books, and it's entitled, Come All We Thankful People. Come All We Thankful People. And beloved, we need to learn to be thankful. Don't care how small the thing is, let us learn to give thanks to God, for this is His will concerning us in Christ Jesus. May you have a blessed day in the Lord. And again, thank Him for waking you up this morning and clothing you in your right minds. Until next time, keep safe and God be with you.